my class. This is Deepak, your maths teacher from Mount Hazi School, Jhansi. I hope you all are utilizing this time and are trying to bring the best out of it. So without taking much time, we'll directly move to topic list. The very first topic that I'll be covering today is the basics of addition. Second one is fill in the missing number. The third one is adding in different orders. The very first topic, that is basics of addition. So what is the meaning of the word basic itself? It means from the root. We'll start revising the topic addition from the very first of, from basic, right? So addition means to add the numbers, right? How? Like we say 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. It means that we are adding 2 plus 2. We are adding 2 and 2. So we got the result 4. So we'll directly move to the larger numbers. This is something which we do in UKG class, right? Let's say we write the number 2, 3, 4, 6 plus 1, 3, 9. So first I'll tell you, we move from the right side to the left side, right? We move this way in addition. So 9 plus 6 goes to 15, 5 and carry 1. 4 and 1 is 5, 5 and 3 is 8. 3 and 1 is 4 and we're 2 over here. So what is the answer? It's 2485. Okay? So this is the way we do addition. So the basis of addition, I think we are very clear with the basis of addition. We try to add two numbers and in this way we got the result. Okay?
Yeah.
It is fill in the missing numbers. So what is the meaning of the word missing? Missing means that something is not there. Right? As you can see in the given question, that there are few numbers given and in though between those numbers there are these dash. Okay? These dashes signify and represent that there is a number missing over here. Right? And you can see the sign of addition. It means while addition, we got some answer. And even to the answer, the few numbers are missing. So we'll directly move to the thing that addition, while we add sum minus a number is equals to other number. Which means as sum means the given answer. 7 is over here, right? So we write 7 over here. 7 minus the other number, that is 4, okay? Gives the other number, which means the number which is missing. So the number which is missing over here is 7 minus 4 is equals to 3. So what will we enter over here? We'll enter 3 over here, right? So it is 4 plus 3 is equals to 7. And now it is given 8 and 3. So we know how to add. 8 plus 3 is 11. So 11, 1, carry 1. Okay? Now, 5 and 1 is 5 and 1 is 6. And here the answer is 8. So again we will do subtraction. 8 minus 6 is equals to 2. So what is the number which is missing over here? That is 2. So we will write 2 over here. We can recheck it. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 and 5 is 8. Clear? Now, this number. 5 and 7. 7 and 2. 7 and 2 is 9. So we can write 9 over here. And now the last number, that is 5. Again 7 is given over here. 7 minus the number which is given over here, which is 5, is equals to 7 minus 5 is equals to 2. Okay? So the number which is missing over here is 2. Now you can check it. 4 and 3 is 7. 8 and 3 is 11. 11 to 1, carry 1. 2 and 1 is 3. 3 and 5 is 8. 7 and 2, 9. 5 and 2 is 7. So in this way we can clearly check out that how to find out the missing number. The third topic, that is adding in different orders. So the first thing which you need to keep in mind while you're doing addition and you're keeping in mind the concept of different orders, right? So the first thing is the sum of numbers in any orders is always same. The best quality of addition is that whenever you add anything, either you add 2 plus 4 or you add 4 plus 2, they're always going to remain same. It means either switch the orders, it doesn't matter at all. Okay? Like say, let's take a number as 2, 4, 8, 3, 6, 9, and 4, 2, 8. We need to add these three numbers in two different orders. So how we do this? In first order, we can directly arrange the numbers in the same order. Like say, 2, 48 plus 3, 69 plus 4, 28. 8 and 8 is 16, 16 and 9 is 25, 5, 2 is 6 and 6 is 12, 22 is 14, 14, carry 1, 4, 5, 5 and 5 is again 10. And now we'll change the order basically. So now the second order would be otherwise, right? Turning it, we'll take this as the first number, 4, 2, 8, second order is 3, 6, 9, third one would be 2, 4, 8. we switched it completely. Okay, the first number over here is the last number over here, so you can see the difference between them. Okay, so 8 and 8 is 16, 16 and 9 is 25, 2 and 2 is 4, 4 and 6 is 10, 10 over 14, carry 1, 5 and 3 is 8, 8 and 2 is 10. So you can directly see that 1045 is completely equal to 1045. So in this way you need to just keep one thing in mind, that while you change the order in addition, the sum always remains the same. It doesn't change. Okay? Thank you so much for